welcome you this night for our Lenten service, our service of evening prayer where we can center together and meet together in this season of fasting and waiting and preparing. We begin, as always, with a call to worship printed in your bulletin. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, source of all goodness and life, who clothes us with Christ Jesus and makes us one by the Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God forever.
Thank you. that easy? Is that easier?
But when I entered this church, talk about helping other, you know, communities, like opening up, you know, clothing place, about people joining in the communal center to, you know, eat together and all that, which we did back home. Made me feel it.
Yeah, there's nothing like a meal to make you feel like
that.
Some food to be failing.
Yeah.
So one of the things I asked you when we talked last week was, what was most important to you about faith? What was the most important thing? And I had to write down, I quoted you. You remember, I pulled out my notebook and wrote it down. Because you said to be honest about the life you live.
Yes.
So the most important thing about faith is to be honest about the life you live. You
want
to talk more about what you mean by that?
Yeah, to me that's very important, because if you meet other Christians and you don't, you're not honest about who you are, about your faith, it doesn't make you feel good. Because I know if you don't be honest with yourself or with your fellow Christians, you're going to slip one day. And that is what a real person, the true person you are. So that's what is very important for me, to be honest, you know, Christian.
That sounds like a lot of humility there.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. The other thing you said, even in that conversation, a couple of the stories you told, and maybe you'd want to share it, about, like, returning to find your mother, looking for her in Liberia after the war. But you know, when I asked you about your faith, you said, All I have to give is love. And what I heard in your stories was that your faith is a response to God's faithfulness. Because do you want to share a little about, like, going back and looking for family?
Yeah, after 14 years of war, at the end of the war, we didn't know where half of our families were. My uncle that ran me through the Lutheran church had been shot and killed while serving in a hospital. So we only heard, we didn't know when it happened. So after the war, I decided to go and find my mother, because I didn't know where she was. I had not heard from them. Most of my siblings, I didn't know where they were. So I went to Liberia. When I got there, there was no transport vehicles going in and out of the country, like we used to. The highways had all been shut down, roads had narrowed because so many years of war, cars were not moving back and forth. But I found this one person who said to me, I have a pickup truck, and if you can put gas in my pickup truck, maybe we can go. And I said, okay. So we put gas, we took a big drum of gasoline and put it in the pickup truck, because there were no gas stations on the way. Then we got about 10 bags of rice. And I got most of my nieces and nephew who had not met their family since the war. And I, being in America, did not know them. So we headed up in the interior. Most places we had to get out of the car, let them push that car through the mud, and then we'll get back in the car and head on again. We got to this first village, and I asked my mom. They said, well, she had gone to a neighboring country. Then all her family members have fled to a neighboring country. But, you know, we can tell them that you're here, and or check another village. If you can sleep, if you sleep here tonight, maybe tomorrow we'll let you know where they are. I said, no, I'm not sleeping here tonight. Just tell me the village. This was about midnight. But the moon was shining like the sun. It was so bright. So we got on the pickup truck and headed up to this village that they told me that my family was. So when we got to this village, it was a makeshift village, because all the people in this area had fled to Guinea. But now, right after the war, they came back. They had no place to stay, because all their homes were destroyed. Our Lutheran church, the Lutheran schools, the hospital, schools along the road, everything was destroyed. Not a thing you see. I went to my village and there was nothing there. So everybody came back and made a makeshift village.
has seen you through all these things, and so you go out and you give, and all you have to give is love, and that's what you show. And her family has grown. Thank you, Auntie Yogie, for sharing.
She's calling me Auntie Yogie. Because she went to Ghana, and in Africa, Liberia and Ghana are not too far apart. In Africa, we don't call older people by name. So they call you either auntie or uncle, whether you're related to them or not. So she started calling me Auntie Yogie.
You all can remember that. Thank you, Auntie. Thank you. I invite you to stand. Let us join together in our prayers. We will sing the response after each petition. Led by Christ in our journey of repentance and moved by his compassion, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. We pray for our church and its leaders.
Thank you.
you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
As always, we're here every Wednesday night. Come on out for a meal and luncheon service as we continue on this journey. And we close tonight with our Sunday hymn 608.